No, we have to do this. There's no hesitation arises. Instead, Suzuha saw only resolve. Have fun.
Yeah,
if I'm a war orphan, I'd love not to go into war. Jesus Christ. This would be the one thing I want to avoid. What the hell's wrong with you? Kagari turned the gun toward the IBM 5100. Oh, you probably don't want to shoot that. You're a piece of shit. Before Suzuha could stop her, she yanked on the trigger, and again and again. And then Kagari jumped out of the time machine. And Suzuha never saw her again. Good fucking riddance. Get out of here. What the hell's wrong with you? What are you looking for? She's crazy. On every night that passed, she remembered Kagari. Suzuha had spent some time looking for Kagari when she'd first come to this era, but in the end, she never found her anything. No, you're not going to. She ran away. Why would you think she'd want to find you to find her? But Shina Kagari, who is now 22 years old, was here in Akihabara. Suzuha was sure of it. But it did no good to keep thinking about it. So Suzuha decided to stop thinking and looked around the room. Oh, God, Daru, stop. Wear a real shirt. Itaru, her dad, was playing yet another game populated entirely with female characters. His jaw was slack, and he was scratching the belly fat that stuck out from under his shirt as he played. There wasn't much respect in him right now, either as a father or as a person. Jesus. No wonder Yuki fell in love with this peak specimen. Jesus. What does it look like it's going well? Yes. Suzuha stormed over to Itaru. Literally, by the time laws, you can't actually fuck up. You will accidentally impregnate her somehow. Motherfucker. You what? She meant the pair of movie tickets that Mayuri and Ferris had conspired to give them to at the Christmas party. Really? Get the fuck out of this place. You don't deserve to have a home. I swear to God, I want him to die. Why couldn't Ocarine have stabbed Daru instead of Kurisu? Where's that world line instead? They're just giving you the money. They're giving you the money to do it, basically. You're still doing everything. And if you don't do anything at all, it's better to just get help than do nothing. I swear to God, I want you to die. Maybe this was a more important problem than the time machine. Suzuha brought her hands up to her head.
いい、父さん。私、いつまでもこうやってお説教できないんだからね。もうすぐ行っちゃうんだよ。
It shouldn't be hard to convince you to want to have sex with Yuki, okay? It shouldn't actually be a work of God to convince you to. Have you seen the way her neck is? Have you seen it? Suddenly there is a sad look in Itari's eyes. For the past 6 months, Suzuha had been thinking about whether it was really right to erase the world. But in the end, it was none other than Itaru who'd pushed her to go ahead. She couldn't bear to see her father so depressed, so she patted his broad back. Probably slightly sweating. He won't. Oh my god. She's gonna die by the time you get around to even asking her for a first date. You can't screw it up. I don't understand this. Why does it take so much effort? Satisfied, she headed off to take a shower. Christ. As healthy as I can. Look, I think you could go at least a week without food, and you'd be fine.
Banira.
Hey.
私、シャワー出たらアイス食べたい。バニラ。
うん、わかった。庶民がなかなか口にできない高級なやつを
いっぱいはいらないよ。一つでいい。
さあ、イエス。
Get the hell out of here, Daru. That was enough to cheer Daru up. He took his wallet out and ran out of the lab.
やれやれ。世話がかかるんだから。
I want to throw myself off a building. It's so unfair. She had just taken off her jacket so she could take the shower, but...
Suzuha!
It's already come back into the lab.
どうかした?
階段のところにさ、こんなの落ちてたんだよね。
Itari showed her a keychain she was holding. He was holding. It was a round anime character whose color had faded to a smoky green. It was an Oopa.
誰のかわかる?
マユ姉さんじゃないの?
No, that's Kagura's. She leaned forward to take a closer look, and when she felt like she was experiencing deja vu.
このウーパーどこかで?
She'd seen it before. She couldn't really remember when. But her internal alarms were going off. This keychain was extremely important. Oopas were common enough that you could find them anywhere. The plastic gadgets had been worn down, the paint was fading and coming off in places. There was no dust, and there were no stains, instead it shone brightly, as if its owner had put a lot of effort into taking care of it. The chain was so old that part of it snapped off. That was probably how it got dropped.
どこだっただろう?どこかで見た?
マユシに見せてもらったとく?
そうなのかな?
She stared at the green Oopa in Itaru's hands, and then in her mind she heard a young girl scream. She gasped. A feeling of indescribable terror raced down her spine.
まさか、かがりのか?
That was when she'd last seen it. August 13th, 2036. The day she'd gone into the time machine. That's when she'd seen this Oopa. It was older and more worn now, but the more she remembered that day, the more certain she became. This was the Oopa that Mayuri had given Kagari. She'd seen Kagari holding in care and crying to herself many times before.
Kagari って、もしかして、未来のマユシの娘?
うん。
見つかったん？
いや、でも向こうはこっちを認識しているんだ。
つまりどういうことだってばよ。
あいつこのラボを監視してるんだよ。
Yeah, it's creepy as hell. Half a year earlier, there had been a person in a riding suit on the roof of Radikan, watching the time machine. Suzuha was convinced the person who had escaped her back then had been Kagari. Ever since then, her careful efforts to defend the time machine had paid off, and she hadn't seen any sign of Kagari, but she never thought she'd be watching the lab.
いや、ちょっと考えれば当たり前のことだったんだ。あいつは私たちがシュタインズゲートに到達するのを阻止しようとしてる。この世界をなかったことにしたくないと思ってる。ということは私だけじゃなく父さんもマークされてる。
え？僕？
まあ父さんの命に危険はないとは思うんだ。世界線の摂理を信じるなら父さんは少なくとも2036年までは生きるはずだし。
And somehow impregnate Yuki because I want to kill myself.
ただシュタインズゲート到達を阻止するために父さんの研究の邪魔はしてくるかもしれない。
That's the most likely scenario here.A lot of bad things have been happening around Suzuha, Itaru, and Okabe Rintaru. There is some possibility that the final target was Itaru.
これからは用心のために、私がいないときには必ずドアに鍵をかけておいて。
You don't lock the door normally anyways?
わかった。
Okay, I'm just really anal about my security. I lock my doors constantly. I have that shit on lock. Even when I am around.Screw it. I don't care if I'm standing by the door. It's getting locked. I hate people. I don't trust people.
オカリン王子さんや母さんやマユ姉さんたちが一緒にいても絶対に開けっぱなしはダメだよ。
Never just leave it open. Even if you're here, I'd keep it locked.
気休めかもしれないけど、ドアチェーンもかけた方がいい。
でもさ、オカリンやマユ氏ならともかく、アマネ氏と二人きりの時にそんなことしたら、なんか別の意味で怪しくね。アマネ氏に変な誤解されないかな。
And?
それは確かに。
Who cares? She'll probably... At some point she enjoys it.
もしそれで嫌われでもしたら、我が家のピンチだお。
It'll be fine. Suzuha groaned softly, unsure what to do.
父さんがもっと早く母さんと恋人になってれば。何の問題もないのに。
It really wouldn't.
で、結局そこへ話が戻るとか？
Yes, we're back to that.
とにかく、注意だけはしておいてよね。
Suzuha decided to keep the green Upa keychain. She softly ran her fingertips over it as she stared at it.
なあ、Suzuha。カガリタンって血はつながってないけど、マユ氏の娘なんだよね。
そうだよ。
Adopted
あのマユシに育ててもらった子が人を襲うような恐ろしい人間になるのかな。
Yeah. Easily.
なんか、スズハの話とイメージが重ならないっつうか、もっと優しくて、ホワホワしてて、可愛い女の子になってるんじゃないかなとか思った。
That's not what I got from the flashback at all.
だと良かったんだけど、私も前はそうなると信じてた。けど今のカガリは多分
some form of really brainwashed. From what she'd seen at Radikan, she could tell Kagari had definitely received professional combat training. It wasn't just the simple self-defense techniques she'd learned from Suzuha when she was a child. As she'd grown up, she'd been taught the cold techniques of a killer.There was no way to know where she'd been, or what she'd been doing ever since she'd gone missing in 1998. But there was no doubt in Suzuha's mind that she was trying to ruin her plans. Suzuha sighed as she took her shower. Since it was summer, she'd set the water temperature low. It was barely any hotter than tap water. As long as the water was pouring down on her, she could feel like all the bad memories were being washed away. She slapped her cheeks with both hands and turned off the water. The small, tiled room suddenly became quiet. In the silence, she vigorously tiled off her hair. This building was never intended for anyone to live in. Not only was there very little room, there wasn't even a place to change. It was small and there were no windows, and the steam from the shower built up, making it an unpleasant sauna in a summer. Supposedly, Taro and Okabe would sit naked next to the fans to get away from the heat and moisture. Of course, that was only when the girls as well as Ushirabara Luka weren't around. I don't think Daru would fucking care at this point. But Suzuha couldn't do that. There was a huge scar on her chest. If she was careless and Yuki saw them, she'd have a big problem. So she forced herself to change it within the small space. It's not like she'll drop by unannounced. The second she left the room, she realized something was wrong. The lights were off in the part behind the curtain where the lab room was. She was sure she'd left all the lab lights on when she'd gone to take a shower. Back into the room and closing the door, locking the door, barricading myself in the door. She didn't remember turning them off. This is why you lock the door anyways. She was still completely naked, but she flung open the curtain. Fuck this. She jumped to the floor ready to move. I'd pull out a gun. She could tell by the light in front of the shower that there was no one else there. She didn't hear any breathing and she didn't feel any other presence. Miss me with this shit. That's creepy. Then when he'd left, he'd turn off the lights? No, that couldn't be right. She looked around the room and saw that things had been moved in a way that an amateur wouldn't be able to notice. Itari's computer desk, the sofa area, the bookshelves, even the mini kitchen, someone had gone through all of them. And from the look of it, the same was probably true of the development room. Suzuha glanced over all the areas where she'd kept her guns. The closest was the sofa and she used as a bed. She'd wanted to have one easily available if she was attacked while she slept, so she'd cut out the back of one of the sofa cushions and hidden a suppressed pistol in it. It was just a 32 for self-defense, so it wouldn't do much damage unless you had good aim. But it was small and relatively quiet, which made it the best choice for a place like this. 32 is not that bad. I mean, okay, sure. Wouldn't do much damage. Suzuha tensed all of her muscles, coiled like a spring, and slowly moved towards the sofa without making a sound. As she did, she tried to notice any changes in her surroundings. There was a small sound in the development room. It was a tiny, tiny creaking of the floor, to which you'd usually pay no attention. But that was more than enough for Suzuha. In an instant, she moved from quiet to action. She cleared the distance of the sofa and in an instant quickly drew a gun. She held it ready and slipped into the shadow of the refrigerator. From this position, she could barely see into the development room. Yo, shoot on sight. The room became silent again, but this time the intruder in the other room didn't try to hide their presence.
おかしな真似をしたら撃つ。手を頭の上に。そのままゆっくり出てこい。
Suzuha threatened the intruder in a low voice, but the intruder seemed completely unconcerned as they exposed themselves to Suzuha's gaze.
この暑いのによくそんな格好をしていられるな。ヘルメットだけでも取ったらどうだ?
The intruder was wearing a motorcycle suit just like before, even the helmet was the same. The leather suit clung tight to their skin, revealing a voluptuous and perfectly proportioned body. It was clearly a woman. How about, fucking no questions asked, just shoot on sight. I mean, it's just fucking me. I'm already putting a fucking... just unloading into her back. Putting like 8 rounds into her back. And then asking, hey, how's it going? Suzuha pointed toward the entrance into the shower room. The shirt she had taken off was lying there on the floor. The girl in the motorcycle suit turned her head. Just because the face mask was drawn, Suzuha couldn't read her expression. The second she spoke, Shina Kagari was the first to move. She drew a deglossed military knife that she must have been hiding behind her back and closed the gap between herself and Suzuha in an instant. Suzuha pointed the gun at her legs and pulled the trigger, carefully aiming away from her vitals. She's gonna stab me! Bitch dies! She heard the small pop of a suppressed 32 and saw Kagari lose her balance and fall. Or just she thought, but it was a feint. You missed? She only pretended to lose her balance. In fact, she changed directions, was heading for the shower room. It seemed her first goal was to get what she'd come for. After firing only one shot, Suzuha realized. Even a 32 should have more recoil than this. She fired again, but Kagari didn't flinch or even for a moment.
Blank cartridge.
Really? At some point, all the bullets in Suzuha's guns had been swapped for blanks. That instant panic was all it took. Kagari reached for the shirt on the floor in front of the shower room. Suzuha gave up on firing and flung the gun at Kagari. Ouchie. There's a dull thud as the hard barrel slammed into her neck. Caught off balance, she staggered before she could grab the shirt. She could hear Kagari's voice from her the first time within the helmet. Suzuha jumped. She kicked off balance Kagari as hard as she could with her toned, muscled legs. This was no time to hold back. Kagari went flying all the way to the edge of the room. They had to have broken a few ribs. Or not. Suzuha jumped toward her to continue her attack. But with terrifying speed, Kagari leapt off the ground and charged at Suzuha. There wasn't enough time to fully come to full speed. A sharp blade swept by mere centimeters from her exposed abdomen. If she'd pulled back even a few tenths of a second later, the knife would have fatally sliced open her gut.
Oh my!
The blood rushed to Suzuha's head. Kagari was serious. She was planning to kill her. There was no hesitation in her movement. No shit! She turned off all the lights and she pulled a knife on you. What do you think she was gonna do? Just play? The hell was wrong with you? You don't pull a knife on someone in the dark in this kind of military style combat situation and not go for a kill. Good lord. Suzuha leapt back and searched for something she could use as a weapon, but the other guns were probably no different. There was a good chance they'd all had their ammo swapped with blanks too. Should have kept a gun in the bathroom. It was even possible that all her self-defense knives had been taken too. Which laughs. There were several knives carefully stored in the kitchen. Yuki had brought them over to use in teaching the girls how to cook. Kitchen knife away. But Kagari had evidently noticed them as well as she was moving to keep Suzuha from reaching them.
Hey, zuibun banare shiteru janai ka.
Suzuha kept her distance from Kagari. She slowly moved along the wall. Her competitive drive burned even brighter as she tried to come up with a way to overcome her disadvantage.
Hora, Kagari, kore daro?
She picked up her shirt from in front of the shower room and took the green keychain out of its pockets.
Doushita? Tori ni kina yo.
Her fingers moved as if to crush it. She could see Kagari twitch for the first time. She could detect a hint of emotion behind the helmet. In an instant, she threw it at Kagari's stomach. The keychain flew in a slow arc, like she was tossing it to a friend. If something they loved was thrown like that, even the fiercest warrior would instinctively reach out with both hands to grab it. Kagari was no exception. She carefully held her mother's memento in both her empty left hand and the right hand, which still clutched the knife. Using the slow arc of the keychain as a camouflage, Suzuha ran at her in a straight line. Her right fist connected hard with Kagari's stomach. Then her left arm smashed Kagari's head to the side. Oh, Steins has started the beating. Kagari's body fell to the ground, her right shoulder taking the brunt of the fall. Rip that helmet off and just start bashing her head into the ground. Suzuha could hear the sound of her joint dislocating. Oh, there's another one. Let's pop it. Keep going. The knife slipped out from her grasp. Oh, look, something to hold you in place. No. Suzuha got behind her and mounted her, twisting her right arm mercilessly. Whoa, okay. At the same time, she slipped down her left arm around Kagari's neck and squeezed hard. Break it. She could hear something like a moan from Kagari's throat. She could both hear and feel the bones in her arm and neck creaking. She's gonna kill you! But Kagari picked up the knife on the floor with her left hand and once again tried to use it on Suzuha. Suzuha was forced to squeeze her arm and neck even harder. I mean, I'm sorry, but there's no... She wants to kill you. I'm sorry. There's no coming back from that. She's not going to. But Kagari didn't stop. If anything, she tried even harder to pull Suzuha away. Even if all the battles she'd been in, this much pressure on two different spots was enough to get even the toughest soldier to submit or fall unconscious. Terrified, Suzuha squeezed even harder. At this rate, she wouldn't simply knock her out. She would kill Kagari. But if she stomped Kagari, would kill her. What should she do? Kill her. I swear to God, if you listen to her. Then she heard a sad, weak voice from inside the helmet. It startled her, and she relaxed both her arms. But that was just what Kagari had hoped for. The knife came very close to cutting Suzuha's left arm. And then when she let go to dodge it, Kagari shook her off and kicked at her hips with both legs. Suzuha was slammed back hard into the computer desk and for a moment couldn't breathe. She fell to the floor and the printer and monitor crashed mercilessly into her naked body. She forced herself to stand up, gasping hard as she did so. Gagari's breathing was heavy too. Her right arm was pointed in an impossible direction, hanging limply. She couldn't be able to use it for a while, probably, but her left arm was still holding the knife.
You
Give a nice kick to that little arm, then. Suzuha glared at Kagure's face, not that she could see what it looked like behind the helmet. The two of them fell silent as they tried to catch their breath. The tension in the air was so thick that it was difficult to move a muscle. Sweat rolled down her forehead and into her eyes, but she still didn't blink as she waited for Kagure to make her next move. It was the sound of the front door opening that broke their stalemate.
Oi, Suzuha!
And Daru's not gonna get stabbed because I fucking hate life. Suzuha felt a chill run down her spine when she heard Itaru's voice. She yelled at the exact same instant he turned on the lights. The sudden brightness was enough to make Suzuha flinch for an instant. Kagure was wearing a full face mask, and that made all the difference. She left towards Itaru just a moment before Suzuha. Kagure's black knife went up to his throat. Kagure spun around behind him, using Itaru's big, huge body as a shield. Suzuha staggered toward him, gritting her teeth. She can kill you, but when it's a Tartar, that's different. Come on! What are you doing? You should have killed her. None of this would have happened. Ah. Fuck sentimentality. But Kagure remained silent as she headed outside the door with her hostage. And in the next moment, she shoved him forward. Oh god. I don't want him. Itaru lost his balance and fell towards Suzuha. Suzuha fell to the ground underneath his weight. Oh god, I'm sorry, Suzuha. Itaru just barely managed to support himself with his arms and legs to keep from crushing her. That would actually probably break her bones. You are not clothed, please don't. Suzuha tried to shove him off, using a little more force than she may have needed or intended. Itaru was so huge that it would take him a moment to get up. She was getting away. She somehow managed to crawl out from under him and quickly tried to follow after Kagure. Itaru was still lying on the ground as he tossed the naked Suzuha her shirt. She grabbed it and quickly put it on and then ran outside. Still don't have any pants on. But when she looked around the street, the girl on the motorcycle leathers wasn't there. There's no way to even know where she'd gone. It's too tense. It'd be dangerous to run around trying to find her now. Suzuha, please just kill her next time. I don't want you to die. I mean, you probably don't die. Hopefully. I pray. There was a chance Itaru would be attacked while she wasn't at the lab. And there's no telling with future Suzuha at this point when she dies. Yeah. Itaru came outside as well. There has to be a reason, though, that she's, like, her face is remaining covered. And, like, Suzuha didn't rip that off. Like, there's gotta be a reason. So she might look like Kurisu now, rather than just having her memories as well. Which would be really, really weird. That's a speculation, at least.
Sukka.
I just don't see why they'd keeping it a secret. What her face looks like. It's gotta be someone. The bruises and wounds were bad enough, but the pain that ached in her heart was all the worst. Yeah, and this is how she treats you.
けど あいつはもう完全に敵だ。
Yo, she'd be my enemy the second she pulls a gun on me. That's when she stops being a friend. That's when she's just a permanent enemy territory. She had all intention to shoot you in the head. It's already strained off her shirt sleeves.
今の Suzuha、なんかエロゲーの地上キャラっぽい格好になってるよ。
Really not the time.
え？
お？ Oh yeah, you're literally just wearing a shirt.Suzuha was caught completely off guard. True, her t-shirt only came just below her hips, roughly the length of a miniskirt. Her breasts were also completely bared. The shirt's hem was turned off and she felt exposed.
まあ僕は地上物も結構いける口なんで、乱れた裸 T シャツというのもありといえばありですが、ムフ
ー。It's still your daughter.
またそうやってふざける。大怪我してたかもしれないのに。
He could have been stabbed. But Itaru shook his head.
僕さ、さっきはナイフ見て騒いじゃったけど、でも怖がる必要なかったんじゃないかなって。
You should have been that scared.
あれがもし僕の聞き間違いじゃなかったら。
Itaru rubbed the part of his neck where the knife blade was.
ナイフを突きつけられてた時。ほんの少しだけど聞こえたんだよ。
何が？
彼女、多分泣いてた。
え？
Crying under that helmet? After that whole battle with Suzuha, while holding a knife to Itaru's neck? But why?
だからさ、決めつけるのはまだ早いんじゃね？
No. I'm sorry. No. No.Like, I know it's gonna probably end up, she's being mind controlled or whatever, so it's actually not that bad. She's actually fine. Still tried to kill me. This is the second time. Technically third, she had the fight off her earlier at the time machine. Third time, she could have been killed by her. At that point, I don't think it's too early to jump to conclusion. I think it's a pattern. But that's just me.
No?
Because when she was a kid, I mean, the argument would be, she just didn't want her mom to, like, you know, Mayuri, all that, PTSD, you know, all that stuff. Still doesn't change the fact she wanted to shoot me. I have a real grudge against people who want to shoot me.
Ice. 買ってきてくれた?
Probably not.
Oh, もちろん.
Oh, wow, you actually did.
食べたいな。私、ちょっと…疲れちゃった。
Only if you put on pants. And then, she almost fell forward. Itaru managed to catch her before she hit the ground.
Oi, Suzuha!
Gomen. Heiki.
She almost died.
Demo.
Well, could have died.
少しだけ休ませ。
She's in a really intense fight.That was all the energy she had to say. She closed her eyes in her dad's arm, and her consciousness melted away.